I used to live in Austin, Texas, from the ages of 8 to 12. So I lived there for about 4 years, and I have a lot of good memories of my childhood from that place. And one of the places I used to live was in an area called Breckenridge Apartments. This apartment complex was pretty large. There was a lot of apartments and other kids to play with, and I remember riding bikes, playing soccer, and just hanging out with the neighborhood kids. So as I drive back into this place, I can see not much has changed. It's a great apartment complex, very safe, and a tight neighborhood. There was all kinds of games we'd play. We'd play soccer and baseball, freeze tag, and of course that famous phrase, "Ollie Ollie Oxen Free." This is the apartment I used to live in, on the right-hand side. And here is where we used to play soccer out in the open field. But even with all those memories, the one that stuck with me the most was a sandwich from Snoopy's Pier in Corpus Christi. So it's been 23 years, and I thought, you know, it's about time I travel down to Corpus Christi to relive the taste of that sandwich. Here I come, Snoopies. When I landed in Austin, Texas, the thing I had to do first, though, was to check out another apartment that we also lived in, where I buried some comic books in the alleyway. Of course, I put the comic books in a thick plastic bag so they wouldn't get damaged, but I didn't bury them very deep. But I tried anyway to see if I could find them next to a tree. Unfortunately, I had no luck. I guess the lesson learned here is that if you want to hold on to your past, you shouldn't bury it. So after that failed attempt at retrieving those comic books, I traveled down to Corpus Christi. I could spot the bridge that led to the island where Snoopy's Pier was located. I do remember this bridge. I remember that we drove down and around and under there before going to Snoopy's. It's a vague memory, but for some reason, I think it was the height of the bridge that stuck in my mind of how tall it was. As I reached the top of the bridge, I could see Snoopy's on the pier. I drive around, heading to the bottom of the bridge, and I could see that it was as tall as I remember. This must be the place. I made my way to the bottom and around the corner. And when I parked my car, the front of the restaurant was beautiful. The first thing I noticed when I walked into the restaurant was a fireplace just for display. There was a lot of seating outside by the ocean. There was even a window that would roll up when the air was calm. So after waiting in line, I could see the menu, the Snoopy burger. That must be the sandwich that I remember.
Heavy boxes, you're ready, heavy boxes.
I ordered that and the half combo, which gave me shrimp, fish, and oysters. So I start looking at the Snoopy burger first. It's got pickles, tomatoes, big onions, cheese, lettuce, mustard. I take my first bite, and it was good. As good as I remember. But it wasn't the first bite I was looking for. It was one of the last bites. A bite that contains the central nexus. The central nexus is made up of all the ingredients of the sandwich in the center. So I make my way eating around the edges of the sandwich first. Looking for the right place on the central nexus, I take a bite with conviction. It was unbelievable. The fish, the shrimp, the oyster sandwich were all fantastic. The Snoopy burger left me with so much nostalgia, I had to travel back. And I did. And I finally ate that sandwich that I longed for 23 years. And afterwards, I sat there in bliss. I left my corporeal body, traveling past the heavens and the earth, out into the universe. I was nowhere and everywhere. I could see all the galaxies and everything in the universe all at once. And after a while, I made my way back to my body. My next stop and visit was instinctive. It was to the beach. The ocean beckoned me out into the waves and surf. I traveled slowly into the ocean, further and further, deeper and deeper. The waves were strong and tried to keep me back, but I knew I had to go out there. I had to go as far as possible, out of curiosity, exploration, to find the end of my journey. And as I made my way further and further, I started to fade into the crashes of the waves. And disappeared, never to return again.